In this vlog, we would like to deal with the new concept Flutter hook in our application. So what are the hooks and why do we require it in our Flutter application? So if you are from a React background, you might have already aware of this particular hook concept. And if you are completely new and beginner to the Flutter, so just don't worry, just follow this particular tutorial. And by the end of this tutorial, you will get a basic knowledge on Flutter hooks and its implementation. So to explain you this particular concept of hooks, I'm just using the basic counter example which we get when we try to create a new Flutter project. So before getting started with this particular tutorial, what is a hook and why do we use it? So now let's try to have some basic introduction on hooks and then we will proceed with our example. So Flutter hooks are the object that will manage the lifecycle of a widget here. So with the help of this particular hook, you can manage the lifecycle of a widget in your Flutter application. So again, what is the lifecycle of a widget? So if you are having a question like, what is the lifecycle of a widget, then here this is a basic introduction for you to the lifecycle. And in our coming tutorials, we will be going through the each component one by one. So the first lifecycle component is create state, then mounted. So thereafter, initState, didChangeDependencies, build, didUpdateWidget, setState, deactivate, dispose, and then mounted is false, that is unmounted. So you might have seen these particular things in your application before. So here you can see we have got createState here, and also you can just specify initState and all these kinds of lifecycle components you will be making use in your application to deal with your particular requirements. So now when we go through this particular counter example here, what we are doing here is like we have specified a counter variable here which is of a type integer here, and we have specified 0 as the initial value, and we have specified an increment counter method here inside which we are trying to set state. So here we have seen a lifecycle component, that is set state here and create state here. So likewise, we'll be using these lifecycle components in our application. So now instead of using this particular set state, we will be making use of hook widget. So that is, instead of a stateful widget here, we will be extending a hook widget so that we need not use set state. And also if you clearly observe here, instead of a stateful widget, where we have two class files here. So the very first one is like my home page class, and the second one is which is extending a state of my home page here. So we are making use of two class files inside a stateful widget, and we can just replace them with a single class file which is extending a hook widget. So now we will try to convert this particular counter example into a single class by making use of a hook widget and try to fetch the same output which we are going to do here. So the rest of the things are very basic things where we have just specified a column inside which we have added a children so that we can have multiple widgets here, and a floating action button to just increment the count here. So now let's try to remove this particular code here. So just I'm going to collapse this and try to remove this particular code so that we can create our own hook widget class, our own class which is extending a hook widget. So before doing so, you need to add hooks, Flutter hooks to your project. So for which, go to the terminal and add this particular dependency, flutter pub add flutter hooks. So this, run this particular command in your terminal so that the dependency will be added to your project. And also there is another way of adding the dependency here. Just move through the pub spec file here, and under the dependencies here, you can just specify this manually, and either of the thing does the same. So now we have added the dependency. So let's start creating a class file. So now let's try to remove the complete stateful widget here and try to create a stateless widget and name it to be hooks example. And now I will try to rename this particular stateless widget to hook widget. Here you can see we have got hook widget in our suggestions, So just select this particular hook widget, and by this time an import will be added to your main.dot file here. So here let's try to rename this to hook example, and now we are good to go. So instead of a container, let's try to return a material app, inside which let's have a scaffold, and inside the scaffold we'll be having an app bar. So these are all the basic things, but this will look good when you add an app bar to your application. So text, and inside which let's specify hooks. So this is a text I'm going to specify for this particular tutorial as an app bar here, inside the app bar here. And now let's try to add a body. So inside which let's try to consider column here, and inside the column we'll be having multiple widgets. So I'm just trying to add a children here, and the very first thing is like a text widget where we are going to display the count. So how many times we have tapped on a button, so that particular count here. And the second thing is like we are going to add a button, so for which let's try to make use of a floating action button. So now let's try to follow this particular structure here. After the app bar we have got a body here, and after this let's try to specify floating action button. So floating action button will have these particular things as a requirement. So they are on press here, and the other one is child here. So these are the basic requirements for every button, not only floating action button, but whenever you are trying to create a text button or any kind of button, then you will be having on press and child. These are the basic requirements, and apart of these two you are having multiple options, even like tooltip, foreground color, background color, all these things you can make use depending upon your requirement. But now these basic things will do our work. So now I'm just going to add, so instead of a text here, basically we use icons here for floating action button so that it appears very easy for the user. So now let's try to add an icon, icons.add. And here inside on press we need to increment the count value, right? So for which now we are going to use hook concept here. So let's try to add a variable counter, and this will use our state here, and here you can see the initial data. So we are trying to increment the number, right? So the initial data will be 0, so from which we will start our count. So if you specify 1 here, so then it will start from 1, and if you specify 2 here, then it will start from 2. So just we start from 0, I'm just specifying 0 here and nothing much. You can just specify whatever the number required here. And now let's try to specify the counter variable here, and straight away you cannot display an integer value inside a text widget here. So you need to enclose it with a string here, such that enclose it inside a string, and I'm specifying a dollar symbol here such that the counter variable is being printed. And before to this you can just add like you have tap, and the counter it will provide the number of times, and later just you can add times here. And now inside the floating action button on press you can just specify counter dot value and increment it. So this is a symbol for incrementing, and for decrementing you can just use minus minus. So now we are good to go, and try to run this particular code and see the output once. So in this particular example we have used state here. So previously we were making use of set state, which is a lifecycle component, and other than this particular use state we are having various other components as well. With the help of hooks we can use them. So here we have got you have tap, and so here you can see we have got the output, but that is not aligned properly. So you can just wrap the column inside a center widget here, and inside the column let's specify main axis alignment to be center. And now let's try to save the code so that our text appears in the center of the screen here. So we are not able to properly read the count here. So now let's try to enclose them in the parentheses here, so that whenever you are having a multiple things to be specified, then you need to enclose them in parentheses. And here just specify value here, and now you can just clearly see you have tapped 0 times. And when we tap on the plus button here, you can see our number is now incrementing. So this is how we can make use of a hook concept in our counter example, which we get whenever we create a Flutter project for the first time. So I hope this concept is clear for you. As this is an introduction tutorial on hooks, we have gone through this particular example. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. And the code for this tutorial will be available in the description section below. So I know this is a very basic tutorial on hooks, and in our coming tutorials we'll be seeing more through this particular topic. And if you are interested, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.